We're at Milestone MX Ranch here in Riverside, California, here for a fun day of the launch of our new Tech 10 boot. It doesn't get any better than the Tech 10. It's worn by more than any other boot in the industry. It's a class-leading boot.
We have our top athletes here, some of the fastest riders in the world, all trying out stock products, putting it through their paces.
For me, the last Tech 10 was perfectly awesome and good, and then Alpinestars comes out with the new Tech 10 that's another level. I've been wearing all this stuff for a while and I get spoiled.
We still have the streamlined multi-density foot hull. The foot hull is a seamless construction, getting all of that weight towards the top half of the boot, making sure that it's not giving any additional stress to the rider's actual foot. Moving up the calf area, high impact absorbing material, and now a newly designed pressure-free zone to the rear of the calf. Our new buckle system is basically an aluminium housing with the receiver that then clamps down the boot itself. It's a millimetric self-aligning buckle system, basically moving in collaboration with all of the flex zones that actually move whilst you're moving around on the boot. We have a double flap. First flap, which comes and securely is highly customizable. It's really sealing out all the elements that goes into the boot. And then we have an impact protector to the front of the boot. Buckle is in, and then we seal out all the elements. We have the front spine that now moves in to the front protector. This is limiting hyperextension to the front of the boot, yet giving control and freedom of movement. Attached directly to the rear and the medial side of the boot, which also incorporates a rubber compound to the inside of the boot, which gives grip and also heat dissipation. Our main focus today is, of course, the launch of our new Tech 10. We also have protection. We have our fluid knee braces. Last, our new BNS neck brace as well.
We have the Bionic Pro using over-injected chest and back panels. So we have here a highly abrasion-resistant Cordura directly over-injected with a plastic, so you can see there's a real shield on top, still backed with the energy-absorbing foam. On the front, again, we have a real shielding. It's not soft, it appears as a textile, but it's real stone shielding. Extremely flexible also, very adaptable to the body, and still extremely lightweight protection. We go to the fluid knee braces. It's basically not only a stabilizing and supporting protection device, but also in terms of impact protection, it fulfills those standards. So also we kept out all material away that is not needed. First of all, to make it highly breathable. So you see these are ventilated sections, and also to reduce weight to a maximum. So here we are speaking about a knee brace that is under 590 grams, still having a CE level, a standard on impact protection. In addition, if we have a completely angled open situation, we have still the protected area. So thinking about riders in U-turns, hitting with the handlebar in the gaps that mostly appear on other braces, we have basically found a nice way of taking out the hits that go up on the thigh. Mainly the BNS, of course, is a highly advanced protection device for motocross, off-road sports. We have a new frame geometry, but also one important point that is the new quick release system that basically has an audio signal of now it's closed. It's very easy, you just throw over your neck support and then just give it a small hit and it closes. On the puller leash, easy to open again. And having this audio signal, you know it's locked, you're safe, you can go on. And then talking about emergency or rescuing system, also important that these two frame members, they can also be taken off completely from a rider. You can take off the back, you open the front, and you completely detach the brace or the neck support. Also, of course, it's an advantage for storage, but we are thinking more about the function or the emergency case reasons.